When you were born, you were not made like this, isn't it? You are so small. Now this much happened, how? So what you call as my body is an accumulation. What you call as my mind is a heap of impressions which you also accumulate over a period of time. So your body is an accumulation, your mind is an accumulation. What you accumulate, at the most you can claim it's yours, but you cannot say it's me, isn't it? So you gathered your body, you gathered the whole volume of your mind. So what the hell are you? Never been looked at, isn't it? You're making assumptions. So your personality, your ideologies, everything picked up, everything accumulated.
Now, when you say that whatever a mind is accumulated, my body is accumulated, that is not me. It is like saying that as long as you can peel the onion, you are not finding the onion. These skins are the onion. This accumulation is me. If you eradicate this accumulation, I don't exist.
Your thought is essentially coming from the information that is already there in your mind, the data that is there in your mind. It's complex, but it is within the limited data that you have. How did you gather this data? This data you gathered through the agencies of five senses, by seeing, by hearing, smelling, tasting and touching. This is the way it's gone into you. These are the five instruments which are taking in all the data in your wakefulness and sleep. These five senses are not reliable. In the sense, if I touch this table, my hand will tell me it's cool. But if I lower my body temperature and touch it, my hand will tell me it's warm. So it doesn't say anything about that. It only tells me the information that is necessary for my survival. If survival is all you're seeking, these five senses are okay. But if you're seeking something beyond survival, you need to expand the dimension of your perception.
First of all, let's not... I mean, the first thing a spiritualist will do, will try to shake your confidence in these five senses that you have. Only then he can control you. Now, if you think that you will believe on any other thing, then take a person, do an operation on him, disconnect him with his brain, and then let us see how he expands his personality. Whatever expansion happens, happens in your mind. And you cannot undermine it. And whoever suggests that that is to be undermined is playing a very dangerous game with you. Because then you will not have any discretion. How will you decide whether whatever he's saying is right or wrong? And whatever he's saying, he's using his brain. He doesn't want you to use your brain. From where this thought has come? Has it come from where? From where it has come? It has come from the mind. Even if you think that the mind is not everything, that too has come from the mind. If you don't trust mind, how do you trust this thought?
If you understand that after all you and me are mortal, whatever we may do. When you understand you're mortal, naturally the question of what is beyond, where did I come from, where will I go, this is naturally in the purview of human intellect. See, if you are not given ready-made answers by somebody, it is very, very natural that every human intellect will inquire, where did I come from, where will I go, what is the nature of my existence?
Why we are in this universe? What are we doing here? Why have we come here? I don't want to comment about anybody else's presence, but Guruji, I know why I'm in this universe, and the reason is unprintable.
And the reason is?
Unprintable.
Unprintable.
It is a pompous question that why I am in this universe. It is a pompous question what I am doing here. Have you ever thought of a mosquito? Why this mosquito is here in this world? Why this cockroach is here? There is, as far as life quality is concerned, there is no difference between a rodent and a human being, between a mosquito and a human being. The only difference is the mind. And this is the difference they want to eradicate.